Hey everyone, Mike from the Excel Trainer here. Funny how plans change, isn't it? This week's video was supposed to be about automating pivot table refresh. I was doing very nicely. I'd built the demo file, I'd created the thumbnail image for YouTube, I'd even got partway through scripting the demos, and then I hit this error. Stay tuned and I'll show you how I resolved it. I came across the error when I was running through the demo prior to recording it. I wanted to attach a macro to one of Excel's VBA events. In this case, it was the worksheet deactivate event, which runs every time a user leaves a specific sheet and selects a different sheet. In the VBA editor, I was in the module for sheet 1. I clicked the drop-down at the top left. I clicked on worksheet, and here's the error. Variable uses an automation type not supported in Visual Basic. I've never seen that message before, but then I do most of my VBA development in Windows. According to a support page on the Microsoft website, in Excel for Mac, a new Visual Basic editor was introduced in October 2017. With this new VBA editor, there's an issue with creating object declarations by choosing from the drop-down menu at the top of the code window. On that same support page, Microsoft provides three ways to resolve the issue. Fix number one, use a computer running Excel for Windows and then copy the code to Excel for Mac. I'm not even going to comment on that one. Fix number two, go to the MSDN and find the syntax for the event you wish to use and type the code manually into your VBA project. I guess many users don't know what MSDN is. It stands for Microsoft Developer Network, and I've provided a link to the not-so-friendly website in the video description below. And fix number three, copy the appropriate event code from the samples on the support page and paste it into your VBA project. Microsoft, these are workarounds, not fixes. And five years later, I would have expected a fix, not some half-baked workarounds. Of course, it may not be Microsoft's fault. Apple are known for tinkering with the operating system and could well have crippled the feature. I guess we'll never know who's to blame. Anyway, if you do hit this problem, rather than going off to a Microsoft support page, download the Excel file that I've provided, links in the description below. The file contains a VBA module containing all the code you need. All you need to do is open the file and switch to the VBA editor. If the event you need to create is a worksheet event, double-click the Sheet 1 module. If the event you need to create is a workbook event, click the This Workbook module. Find the appropriate event, select it, and copy and paste it into the appropriate module in your own workbook. And what about the original video, How to Automate Pivot Table Refresh? Stay tuned, I'll do that one next week. As always, if you found this video useful, please give it a like. And if you're not already subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel. If you have any suggestions for future videos, please let me know in the comments. My free weekly newsletter is packed with tips and tricks to help you become more productive in Excel, and you can sign up for that at theexceltrainer.co.uk. But until the next time, have an excellent day.